What's up, guys? We are in the year 2020. Can you believe that? And now it's time to count down my top 10 favorite films of the last decade. Favorite horror films. Anyway, let's get it going. What is up, guys? First off, I want to give a big thank you to Jacob from Cinema Junkies. Check out his channel, Cinema Junkies. He literally just sent me this t-shirt and another t-shirt that says Tom Atkins Rules. I'll show it to you. Yeah, here's the other t-shirt he sent me in the vein of Monster Squad. But yeah, I wanted to give him a shout out because I literally just opened this. Suspiria with Japanese writing. My God, this freaking t-shirt. But yeah, so thank you so much, Jacob. Definitely check out his channel. Anyway, the last decade has offered up some really great horror movies, and this was a really, really tough list to narrow down. Keep in mind, yes, I'm going to take into account the quality, the filmmaking of these movies, but also my personal entertainment. That's a big part of this too. So don't get mad if your favorite movie of the last decade, favorite horror movie, is not on this list. All right. Also, I'm going to give you two honorable mentions because I have to. I mean, there's a lot of movies that I want to mention on here. So anyway, the first honorable mention, I'm going to say Halloween 2018. I think given what this franchise has been through, what David Gordon Green offered up was almost a miracle. You know, to give us a story that was actually pretty frightening, pretty chilling, giving us one of the best versions of the character of Michael Myers, the best score out of the whole franchise, in my opinion. Thank you, Mr. John Carpenter. Those three things alone, or did I mention four things, put it on the honorable mention for this list. Yes, it did have some problems, but I still really love this movie, actually, and I'm really looking forward to Halloween Kills, which was my number one most anticipated horror movie of 2020. Next honorable mention has got to go to a movie that I just fell in love with a couple years ago, Green Room, just because of how different it was. I happen to be a musician, and this involved musicians, and I like that the first act of the movie was really just letting you be a fly on the wall in their world and you know what punk musicians go through. And then all of a sudden it turns into this really graphic, really nail-biting thriller horror movie. I mean, it's really graphic, actually, and it doesn't hold back, and I just had to mention this movie for an honorable mention. And rest in peace, Anton Yelchin, who gives a phenomenal performance in this movie. Okay, number 10 is going to be Evil Dead, the remake. I tried my best to avoid putting remakes on this list, but you know what? There are a couple of really great remakes out there that ended up on this list. And this was definitely one of them. Probably one of my favorite remakes ever. You know, aside from John Carpenter's The Thing. I love that this remake had balls, you know, not having Ash Williams in the movie whatsoever, except for that after credit scene. But Jane Levy holding the fort on her own and just delivering a great commanding performance. And this is easily the bloodiest Evil Dead movie of the whole bunch. Loved the story, loved everything, the characters, but really the kills. The graphic violence in this movie did not hold back whatsoever. Thank you, Mr. Fede Alvarez, for directing this. One of my favorite directors working today in the horror department. Number 9 is a good old like psychological, I guess, thriller, The Invitation, which surprised me, actually. I saw it a few years ago. I think it was on like Netflix or something like that. But this is one of those movies that just really just percolates in your brain after you see it. And I like movies that kind of involve like cults because you never know where these types of films are going to go. And this movie just got really dark. But what really sells the darkness of this movie are the performances. Logan Marshall Green is the main character in this. And I believe he's going through like some marital issues, a divorce. But all these couples, they get together and you never know where this thing's going to lead. And it is one of my favorite like endings of the last decade. And I'm not going to spoil anything on that, just in case some of you haven't seen The Invitation, because it's not like a widely known film. But it was so good that it puts it on this list. Number 8 is a movie that I totally adored, fell in love with, Starry Eyes. Starring Alex Esso. Another one of those movies that's, I guess, kind of a lower budget independent type of film, but it involves like, you know, LA and the acting business and what actresses go through. I like horror movies that really set things up and let you get to know the characters. And this one does a great job at that. And you never know where this movie is gonna go, but it gets really dark and graphic. But again, it involves like a satanic cult and all this really crazy wild shit. But as far as like last acts that are just completely insane, this one takes the cake. And I actually met Alex Esso at Spooky Empire, and I had her sign that poster for me back there, which is really cool. And I told her, I was like, the performance you gave in this movie I thought was amazing, but the movie itself was just, it really just stays with you, you know? And you get to see a little bit of, you know, the acting profession in LA and how superficial and how just full of themselves people can be. So this movie offers up a lot of different elements, and some of you might not have seen this movie, so I'm glad I put it on this list. Number 7 is Us, Jordan Peele. I have to give the guy credit. I wasn't even the biggest fan of Get Out. I thought it was a little overrated, very well-directed film. So I was a little cautious, skeptical going into Us, but it proved me wrong. It proved to me that Jordan Peele is one of our best horror directors working today. This was such an inventive premise. You know, the enemy is you. You know, it literally looks like a family, an identical family of your own family, and they attack this family. I said family too many times. But in terms of like filmmaking and putting a story together and just building a world, this movie does it perfectly. It was one of my favorite movies of this year, and that ending is just brilliant. And I do think, even though there are a lot of people that didn't like Us, because I got a lot of comments on my social media saying Us was crap, I didn't like it whatsoever. It's a polarizing type of film, and I think that's what draws me to polarizing films. I like films that don't necessarily appeal to everybody, to the mass audiences. This is that type of film, and there's going to be a couple of those types of films on this list, actually. You know, I like movies that push boundaries and maybe alienate themselves from certain audiences. This one definitely does that. Number 6, I'm going to cheat a little bit. Prometheus. Prometheus, to me, is a horror movie. It's in the Alien franchise, but it's more on the sci-fi side. But Prometheus offered up so many ideas. And to have a movie that only introduces the xenomorph in like the very last scene of the movie, and it didn't even need it. Because this whole world of the engineers and the space jockey and just explaining all that, but offering even more questions along the way, which is a good thing. I like movies that offer questions that don't tell you everything. This one was beautifully directed too, by the way, Mr. Ridley Scott. It's crazy to me that this many movies into the Alien franchise and you walk away from it just completely floored and just thinking about it. For lack of a better phrase, it's a movie that will not leave your brain, and it's a movie that gives and gives every time I watch it. And I actually loved Covenant as well. You know, Covenant is more on the alien side of things. It's more on the horror side of things and darker, and I thought about putting that one instead of this one because I like both of them equally. But I think Prometheus did it first, so I have to put Prometheus on the list. Number 5, a good old-fashioned slasher, you're next. And I think what Adam Wingard brought to the table with this one is just offering up something else besides the regular cookie cutter formula, you know, offering up a final girl that is just as, if not even more dangerous than the killers themselves. 3 killers in this movie, and they're running for their lives from Miss Shawnee Vincent in the last act of this movie. I mean, she is a force in this movie. I liken this to like the female Rambo. And Your Next is just such a blast, such a fun time of a movie. And I definitely wanted to throw one of those on here, and I think in the slasher genre for the last 10 years, I think Your Next has done it almost perfectly. Number 4, another remake, Suspiria. You see why I wore this shirt now? The Suspiria remake does exactly what a remake should do. It takes some of the greatness from the original, but then forms its own voice. And it is a completely different movie than what Dario Argento brought to the table. And you don't want to copy Dario Argento because you're going to get yourself in a lot of trouble. He is, still to this day, probably one of my favorite horror directors out there. And I'm glad that this movie just went in a completely different direction in terms of like tone and vibe. The score by Tom York is amazing. Look, I am a Suspiria fanatic. The original is in my like top 10 favorite horror films of all time. And to bring a remake to the table that is, I would dare say, just as good as the original is no easy feat whatsoever. I can't think of very many remakes out there that do that. And this one does that, and it gets you thinking. You constantly can't get this movie out of your head. Number 3, a movie from 2015. by the great Robert Eggers, The Witch. This was such a thought-provoking type of horror film. Dare I even say, like, artsy. It's one of those types of horror films. And you can have an artsy horror film, but you still want to make it scary. And this was definitely one of the scariest movies of 2015, if not one of the scariest of the last decade. There are scenes in this movie that will make you feel extremely uncomfortable. But it does everything that I think a great horror film should do. And it presents questions too, because our main character, Anya Taylor-Joy, when I first saw this movie, I kind of had a different opinion about her character than I did with repeat viewings. And maybe that's my own fault, but this movie definitely offered up some challenging ideas about religion and, you know, about witchcraft even. And I think it handled it on such a mature level. And not spelling out everything for you, but you know, after watching it more and more, the end really reveals itself to me in a much more clear fashion. That's a roundabout way of me saying I was too stupid to figure it out on the first watch. Number two, a South Korean film, The Wailing. This movie left such an impression on me. I was just floored by it. I think it might have been my first South Korean film that I'd ever watched. Talk about ambitious. If you want ambition in your horror movies, and this deals with themes of like the occult and the supernatural, really just basic good and evil, but directed in such a beautiful fashion. The Wailing is a movie that I think requires multiple viewings. I've watched it probably three times now, and it's just one of those movies that will never leave your skull. Just visually, the imagery in this movie is just insane, and it's another one of those movies that you could come up with so many different theories about what it all means, because it definitely doesn't spell out anything whatsoever. There are YouTube analysis videos on The Wailing and what a lot of the themes in this movie mean. And that's one of the things that I love so much about The Wailing. And it's one of those movies that you're thinking, there's no way they're gonna actually go the direction they go at the end of the movie. You know, being that literal. And I'll just say, you might be surprised. And then number one, this is gonna piss off half of you probably. It Follows, and no apologies whatsoever. It Follows, I think, is if not the best horror movie in the last decade, maybe even the best horror movie in the last 20 years. It really is that effective. Directed beautifully by David Robert Mitchell. When this came out, you could definitely see that Carpenter influence there, but he offered up a lot of his own ideas in the direction of this movie and how to scare an audience. Really the premise itself, you know, sex being the killer in this movie. It's really like a metaphor for STDs. But for me, it came down to the horror in this movie. This is one of the few movies that genuinely sent chills down my spine probably over the last few years. And it takes a lot to like scare me. In this movie, there are a couple scenes in this movie that just are so unsettling. And a big part of that too is the score by Disaster Piece, which I actually have the vinyl of that score. And there's quite a few tracks, like some are like beautiful sounding and then some are just really creepy. If you put like synth in a score, I think that's a big step up for me. Everybody loves that 80s culture. But to me, I think synth works great for horror scores. And this is one of my favorite scores probably of the last decade, as well as the movie. So anyway, guys, that's my top 10 favorite horror movies of the decade. Looking forward to seeing yours down below, because I know there's so many that I did not put on this list. So looking forward to seeing what you guys have. Also, be sure to come over to Killer Flicks, where we talk horror all day and every day, and on Fridays. We do Free For Fridays. Follow me at Drumdums on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Letterboxd. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and Drumdum out.